So, Katie, just to start the interview with, can you just tell us what is the work? Just describe the work.
Yes, I'm happy to. The work is a way to identify and then to question the thoughts that you yourself are thinking, the thoughts that cause all the suffering and all the violence in the world.
A stressful thought that I can often have is, I don't have enough money.
Mm-hmm.
So if we can just do the work on this concept of, I don't have enough money.
Well, on anyone that has the thought, I don't have enough money, the mind's job is to do everything it possibly can to hold that belief in place. Because when that belief is held in place, an identity is established. In other words, my identity is I am the person that does not have enough money, okay, for example. So the work is a way to break that spell. And I don't say it will break the spell, but if a person really wants to know the truth, a lot can be discovered there that can shift that identity and that reality totally. So the work would work like this. I don't have enough money. So if all viewers now would consider that a time when they have had that thought, or maybe you're actually believing it now. So you don't have enough money. First question of the four, is it true? You don't have enough money. Is it true? And then I invite you not to just go, yes, it's true. I invite you, if your mind should work that way, you're so convinced, to give no equal opportunity, to give it equal time, to consider the no. Not to use consideration to change your mind at all, but to contemplate and give equal time to that no. And the answer to the first two questions is either yes or no, because the mind will want to say no but, or no because, or yes because. So just to notice all that mind chatter and to get still, notice, and then contemplate just on one of those two answers, yes or no. So after you have sat in that, a lot of stillness is very useful in that. You know, the work is meditation. And then the second question, you don't have enough money. And I hear that some of you are very convinced. And I ask you, can you absolutely know that it's true? You don't have enough money. Can you really know that that's true? And then to contemplate that question. Are you sure that that's true? That you don't have enough money? And then the mind will seek, if you keep it focused on that question, and the discoveries are often mind-blowing. Okay, so those are the first two questions. Third question, how do you react? What happens when you believe that thought? What happens to your emotional life? What happens to your physical life? What happens to your life for those of you that have addictions involved, substances, any compulsive, obsessive behaviors? Notice in that third question, as you become very still in that question, how do you react? What happens when you believe that thought? You don't have enough money. Notice the terror. Notice the way you affect people, the people in your life that are around you. Notice how you are affected internally. Notice the images that come of past and future. That's quite a question when you get very still with it. How do you react when you believe the thought you don't have enough money? And then that fourth question, who would you be? Who would you be without that thought? Now, this is not a question that says, please go into denial. Far from that. I'm inviting you to look at your life just the way you have lived it, going to the market, just sitting the way you are now, maybe viewing this image. And contemplate that same life. Don't change anything. and just witness that life without the thought, I don't have enough money. And notice. Notice, sit in those images that were so fearful prior to this question and open your mind to it. And for some of you, that's a very frightening question to sit in. It's almost as though if you didn't have that thought in your life that there is some kind of belief running maybe that you would never have cause to get a job or to keep your job or to seek out funds or support. And that's not the case. It's just mind again. Just wonderful, wonderful trickster mind again. Dear mind again. Just doing its job, doing its job, whatever it takes to hold you in that identity. So I invite you, those of you courageous enough, those of you that really want to be free, those of you that are really interested in peace inside yourself, what would your life look like without the thought that you don't have enough money?